Hello, and this is Talia again. This is chapter 4, part 2. Past the ruined church, then down into the little valley below. This part of the cemetery was well kept. It was the old section that was allowed to run slightly wild. Here the grass was neatly trimmed, and bouquets of flowers made splashes of bright color. Elena sat down by the big marble headstone with Gilbert carved into the front. "Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad," she whispered. She leaned over to place a purple impatiens blossom she'd picked along the way in front of the marker. Then she curled her legs under her and just sat there. She'd come here often after the accident. Margaret had been only one at the time of the car crash. She didn't really remember them, but Elena did. Now she let her mind leaf back through memories, and the lump in her throat swelled, and the tears came easier. She missed them so much still. Mother so young and beautiful, and Father with a smile that crinkled up his eyes. She was lucky to have Aunt Judith. Of course, it wasn't every aunt who would quit her job and move back into a little town to take care of two orphan nieces. And Robert, Aunt Judith's fiancé, was more like a stepfather to Margaret than an uncle to be by marriage. But Elena remembered her parents. Sometimes, right after the funeral, she had come out here to rage at them, angry with them for being so stupid as to get themselves killed. That was when she hadn't known Aunt Judith very well, and it felt there was nowhere on earth she belonged anymore. Where did she belong now, she wondered. The easy answer was here, in Fells Church, where she lived all her life. But lately, the easy answer seemed wrong. Lately, she felt there must be something else out there for her, some place she could recognize at once and call home. A shadow fell over her, and she looked up, startled. For an instant, the two figures standing over her were alien, unfamiliar, vaguely menacing. She stared, frozen. "Elena," said the smaller figure, fussily, hands on hips. "Sometimes I worry about you. I really do." Elena blinked and then laughed shortly. It was Bonnie and Meredith. "What does a person have to do to get a little privacy around here?" she said as they sat down. "Tell us to go away," suggested Meredith. But Elena just shrugged. Meredith and Bonnie had often come out here to find her in the months after the accident. Suddenly she felt glad about that, and grateful to them both. If nowhere else, she belonged with the friends who cared about her. She didn't mind if they knew she had been crying, and she accepted the crumpled tissue that Bonnie offered her and wiped her eyes. The three of them sat together in silence for a little while, watching the wind ruffle the stand of oak trees at the edge of the cemetery. "I'm sorry about what happened," Bonnie said at last in a soft voice. "That was really terrible. And your middle name is Taxa, Meredith. It couldn't have been that bad, Elena. You weren't there." Elena felt herself go hot all over again at the memory. "It was terrible, but I don't care anymore," she added flatly, defiantly. "I'm finished with him. I don't want him anyway." "Elena!" "I don't, Bonnie. He obviously thinks he's too good for Americans, so he can just take those designer sunglasses and..." There were snorts of laughter from the other girls. Elena wiped her nose and shook her head. "So," she said to Bonnie, determined, changing the subject, "at least Tanner seemed in a better mood today." Bonnie looked martyred. "Do you know that he made me sign up to be the very first one to give my oral report? I don't care, though. I'm going to do mine on the Druids." "And on the what?" "Druids, the weird old guys who built Stonehenge and did magic and stuff in ancient England. I'm descended from them, and that's why I'm psychic." Meredith snorted, but Elena frowned at the blade of grass she was twirling between her fingers. Bonnie, did you really see something yesterday in the palm? In my palm? She asked abruptly. Bonnie hesitated. I don't know, she said at last. I really thought I did, then, but sometimes my imagination runs away with me. She knew you were here, said Meredith unexpectedly. I thought of looking at the coffee shop, but Bonnie said she's at the cemetery. Did I? Bonnie looked faintly surprised but impressed. Well, there you see. My grandmother in Edinburgh has the second sight, and so do I. It always skips a generation. And you're descended from the Druids, Meredith said solemnly. Well, it's true. In Scotland, they keep up the old traditions. You wouldn't believe some of the things my grandmother does. She has a way to find out who you're going to marry and when you're going to die. She told me I'm going to die early. Bonnie! She did. I'm going to be young and beautiful in my coffin. Don't you think that's romantic? No, I don't. I think it's disgusting, said Elena. The shadows were getting longer, and the wind had a chill to it now. Okay, I'm going on to the next page. And this, I will continue.